with singing. It was so hard. Crazy, man.
Thank you. Blessed be the one holy and living God.
Glory to God.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My heart exalts in you, O God. My
trust is lifted in you.
My mouth derides my enemies,
for I rejoice in your salvation.
There is none holy like you,
nor any rock to be compared to you, our God.
Do not heed of prideful words or speak in arrogance.
Only God is knowing and weighs all actions.
The bones of the mighty are broken,
but the weak are clothed in strength.
Those once full now labor for bread.
Those who hungered now are well fed.
The childless woman has borne sevenfold,
while the mother of many is sworn.
God has spoken to the priest of life,
cast down and raised up.
It is wealth for takes away,
humbles and dignifies.
God raises the poor from the dust,
and lifts the needy from the ash heap,
to make them sit with the rulers
and inherit a place of honor.
For the purposes of the earth are God's,
on which the whole earth is founded.
God be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Lord, make us have perpetual love and reverence for your holy name. For you never fail to help and govern those whom you have set upon the sure foundation of your loving kindness. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The child grew and was weaned, and Abraham made a great feast on the day that Isaac was weaned. But Sarah saw the son of Hagar, the Egyptian, whom she had borne to Abraham, playing with her son Isaac. So she said to Abraham, "Cast out this slave woman with her son, for the son of this slave woman shall not inherit, along with my son Isaac." The matter was very distressing to Abraham on account of his son. But God said to Abraham, "Do not be distressed because of the boy and because of your slave woman. Whatever Sarah says to you, do as she tells you. For it is through Isaac that offspring shall be named for you. As for the son of the slave woman, I will make a nation of him also, because he is your offspring." So Abraham rose early in the morning and took bread and a skin of water and gave it to Hagar, putting it on her shoulder along with the child, and sent her away. And she departed and wandered about in the wilderness of Beersheba. When the water in the skin was gone, she cast the child under one of the bushes. Then she went and sat down opposite him a good way off, about the distance of the bow shot. For she said, "Do not let me look on the death of the child." And as she sat opposite him, she lifted up her voice and wept. And God heard the voice of the boy. And the angel of God called Hagar from heaven and said to her, "What troubles you, Hagar? Do not be afraid, for God has heard the voice of the boy where he is. Come, lift up the boy and hold him fast with your hand, for I will make a great nation of him." Then God opened her eyes, and she saw well water. She went and filled the skin with water and gave the boy a drink. God was with the boy, and he grew up. He lived in the wilderness and became an expert with the bow. He lived in the wilderness of Paran, and his mother got a wife for him from the land of Egypt. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray together that the portions of Psalm 86 that is found in your bulletin.
Bow down your ear, O Lord, and answer me, for I am poor and in misery. Keep watch over my life, for I am faithful. Save your servant, for I put my trust in you. Be merciful to me, O Lord, for you are my God. I call upon you all the day long. Gladden the soul of your servant, for to you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. For you, O Lord, are good and forgiving, and great is your love for all who call upon you. Give ear, O Lord, to my prayer, and attend to the voice of my supplications. In the time of my trouble, I will call upon you, for you will answer me. Among the gods, there is none like you, O Lord, nor anything like your works. All nations you have made will come and worship you, O Lord, and glorify your name. For you are great, you do wondrous things, and you alone are God. Turn to me and have mercy upon me. Give your strength to your servant, and save the child of your handmaid. Show me a sign of your favor, so that those who hate me may see it and be ashamed. Because you, O Lord, have helped me and comforted me.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Should we continue in sin in order that grace may abound? By no means. How can we who die in sin go on living in it? Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of God, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all, but the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Give me understanding, O Lord, and I shall be your law with all my heart. Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said to the 12 apostles, "A disciple is not above the teacher, nor a slave above the master. It is enough for the disciple to be like the teacher, and the slave like the master. If they have called the master of the house Beelzebul, how much more will they malign those of this household? So have no fear of him, for nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing is secret that will not become known. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the light, and what you hear whispered, proclaim from the housetops. Do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather fear him who can destroy both the soul and the body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs of your head are all counted. So do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. Everyone, therefore, who acknowledges me before others, I also will acknowledge before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before others, I also will deny before my Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to bring peace to the earth. I have not come to bring peace, but a sword. For I have come to set a man against his father, and a daughter against her mother, and a daughter-in-law against her mother-in-law. And one's foes will be members of one's own household. Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up the cross and follow me is not worthy of me. Those who find their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake will find it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Through the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts, be acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer.
Amen.
There's one problem with our lectionary. It assumes that everybody was here last week and everybody remembers what the gospel lesson was last week. So, to put this reading in context, before this scripture, what we read last week, God, Christ, Jesus commissions the 12 apostles to go out and heal, cast out demons, preach, go from town to town, be God's emissaries in the world. Names the 12 apostles. Those who are sent. Then he starts talking about houses that will welcome you and houses that won't welcome you. And then we get in what's called the missionary discourse in Matthew. Jesus preaching about what it's like to be a missionary in the name of God. Many people think this was written specifically for the Matthaean community who had been cast out, had lost their family, had lost their place of worship. So I want to look at this in the light of what Jesus is telling us, what Jesus was saying at the time, not after his resurrection. The teacher and the student, the master and the slave. Well, the student can't aspire to be more than the teacher. Now that sounds a bit like the professor at the desk saying to his students, you're never going to surpass where I am. But that's not what Jesus is saying. Jesus has been compared to Beelzebub, the prince of demons. What Jesus is saying, if you follow me, if you teach in the name of Christ, those who believe I am the devil are not going to think any differently of you. Those who follow Christ will be compared to Christ. And in this name, mothers and daughters are going to fight. Fathers and sons are going to fight. And we see this. This is not something that only happened when the formation of the Christian community happened, but it happens every day. We get set in our ways of Christian behavior, and we think too much on right according to the law, and we forget that Christ is a God of love. He says, I came to bring a sword, not peace. He knows the division that is going to happen when people start worshiping God. People start worshiping God of love, not a God that demands petty following of rules. Yes, there are behaviors we need to observe. Paul knew that. He writes all about faith. He never discounted behavior. But family against family. Christian against Christian. It seems that's where we are. We don't even seem to worship the same Christ. We are separated, cast out. Choices in life are having parents throw their children out of the house. Brothers and sisters not speaking to each other. Forming more and more Hagars in our world. Those who are cast out of their home for no fault of their own. Now look at that Hagar story, and I don't see much good behavior. Sarah, I can't agree with her. Abraham didn't do very well, and I question what God was saying in this scripture. Yes, we could say God knew it was going to work out. So I won't question him too long. I'll wait until I see him face to face and we can talk about it. But Abraham, do not think Abraham was being righteous. He could have given her a wagon of provisions, sent guards and soldiers, given her a piece of land to live on. But no, some bread and a water skin, and puts the child on her shoulder. Sends her into the wilderness for sure and certain death. Cast out. When I look at this world, and I see this example play over and over again, where people are cast out. Often in the name of God. Often in the name of Christ. Christian against Christian. That's not what Jesus is teaching. These verses, love me more than your mother, love me more than your father, these are used too often to forgive misbehavior, to forgive us renouncing our family, renouncing our loved ones, renouncing other Christians. Yes, I hear preaching, but I am not innocent of these charges. I am just as guilty of embracing this division that exists between Christians. I'm on this side. And if they want to come over to this side, great. I'm not going over to their side. That's not what Christ calls for us. Christ calls for us to go forward. Yes, there will be divisions. And Christ brings a sword. Christ does not put that sword in our hands. Christ puts the sword in those that want to cleave us apart, want to divide us. But it's not without hope. For it is enough for the student to be like the teacher. And who is the teacher? Jesus Christ. It is enough for us to be like Jesus Christ. Sets a pretty high bar. But we can try. Try to be like Christ. And proclaim it from the rooftops. Proclaim it to the world. That's why he's sending these apostles out. He knows. There are people thirsting for this information, to be told they are loved, to be told that God loves them, to be told they are welcome. This is not an exclusionary text. It is not an us and them text. This is a text that says, bring everybody in, invite everybody in, ask everyone to come in and enjoy and love and celebrate God. There is no biblical excuse in this text to divide ourselves. Okay, what about that love me more than your mother? If you love Christ, if you love God above all else, you're going to love your mother. You're going to love your father. You're going to love your neighbor. You're going to love those that disagree with you or have a different point of view. There's nothing in here about not liking your mother. There's nothing in here about love me and leave them. No. We cannot just think about this reading all by itself without understanding who Christ is, what he taught. Love God. Love self. Love neighbor. The sword is in the hand of those that want to tear us asunder. Now Christ acknowledges. He put this sword in their hand. But the defense is not another sword. The defense is love. The shield of love. We too often let ourselves get isolated in our own circle. And unknowingly, that circle becomes a wall or a gate. There aren't enough doors on our gate, on our fences. We need more gates. We need to let people in. Guys, let's turn up that, tear down that fence altogether. For now, you, yes, you, you're not excluded, and I am not excluded. We are the apostles of Christ. We are the ones being sent to preach from the rooftops, to preach in the valley, the love of Christ, the all-encompassing, all-inviting love of God. For God does not want us to be divided. God wants us to be one. Divisions exist. But let us be the ones to cross over and show the love of God even when we have disagreements. Even when we have opposing views on issues. For it is the love of God that can shine brightly, so brightly, that there is no room for division. Because it shines a light on all the darkness, all the questions, all is revealed with the ever-loving light of God. It's a lot easier to stay inside the bubble. But God calls us to be sent. Go forth into the towns, into the villages. I'm going to change what Christ said just a little bit. If they don't welcome you, knock on the door again. Knock again. Always share the love of God. In the name of Christ.
We believe in one God,
Father the Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and then he became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe
Spirit of God aids us in our weakness and teaches us to pray. In the power of the Spirit, let us offer prayers to God for the needs, concerns, and hopes of all the world. For the holy churches in every place, and for the unity of all. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for the Church of Bangladesh. In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for the mission and ministry of St. Paul's congregation in Chini, Kennewick, and Walla Walla. We also give thanks for the birthdays of the Reverend Jake Andrews and Achilles Keeley Alabadas. We pray especially for the health and well-being of our Bishop Gresham, that you will be with her as she awaits her surgery. O God, hear us.
God graciously hear us.
For our parish, St. Timothy's, our clergy, Colby and Joan, our wardens, officers, vestry, committees, congregation, and those in our parish cycle of prayer, Alice Whitaker, Peter and Shirley Young, and Wendy and Cherish Abercrombie, that we will faithfully bear witness to the risen Christ in word and deed. O God, hear us.
God, graciously hear us.
For those in positions of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every human being, for the peace of the world, that the spirit of peace and forbearance may grow among people and nations. O God, hear us.
God, graciously hear us.
For members of the armed forces, diplomatic corps, and aid workers serving worldwide, and for their loved ones who await their return. O God, hear us.
God, graciously hear us.
For our service workers who remain unknown and are rarely thanked, and for healthcare and public safety workers, for all those in danger and need, the sick, the suffering, the oppressed, and the dying. We pray especially for
Tad, Jean, Lois, Sonia, Annie, Adela, Pam, Dick, Dennis, Sherry.
And for others, we may name out loud or in our hearts. O God, hear us.
God, graciously hear us.
For all those who died recently, remembering especially Wyatt, may they rest in peace and rise in glory. O God, hear us.
God, graciously hear us.
Remembering the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Timothy, and all the saints, let us offer ourselves and one another to the living God through Jesus Christ.
To you, O Lord, our God.
Almighty and eternal God, ruler of all things in heaven and earth, mercifully accept the prayers of your people and strengthen us to do your will through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us confess our sins to God. God of all mercy,
we confess that we have sinned against you in opposing your will in our lives.
We deny
your goodness in each other, in ourselves, and in the world you have created. We repent of the evil that has slain us, the evil we have done, and the evil done on our behalf. Forgive, restore, and strengthen us through our Savior Jesus Christ, that we may abide in your love and serve only in your will. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
him.
Much cuter.
Yeah, it's weird. Yeah, definitely weird. Yeah.
Can't start with that.
No.
That's why I'm pregnant.
I'm sure Cena hurt me.
Colby and I will both be old together, so we can be able to.
Walk in love as Christ loved us. He gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving.
Thank you. you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give you our thanks and praise.
God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise.
Glory to you forever and ever.
At your command, all things came to be. The vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets in their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home.
By your will, they were created and have their being.
From the primal elements, you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another.
Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight.
Again and again you called us to return. Through prophets and sages, you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace.
By his blood, he reconciled us. By his wounds, we are healed.
And therefore, we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
And so, Father, we who have been redeemed by him and made a new people by water and the Spirit, now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering now his work of redemption and offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving,
we celebrate his death and resurrection. As we await the day of his coming.
Lord God of our ancestors, God of Abraham and Sarah, Isaac and Rebekah, and Jacob, Rachel, and Leah, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world around us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only, and not for renewal. That the grace of this Holy Communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name.
Risen Lord, be known to us in the breaking of the bread.
Accept these prayers and praises, Father, through Jesus Christ, our great High Priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ has taught us, we now pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins,
as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time to trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Hallelujah! Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Hallelujah!
The gifts of God for the people of God. Thank you. Please stand as you are able. Let us pray.
God of abundance, you have fed us with the bread of life and cup of salvation. You have united us to Christ and one another, and you have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world, and continue forever in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen.
Peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen. Amen. Please be seated. Unless you're coming forward with a birthday or a travel or anniversary, then come up here. Kathy's birthday. Wonderful. Eric and Dana anniversary.
Travel. Anniversary was last week. Travel this week.
3 years.
Three years.
All right, let us turn to page 830 in our Book of Common Prayer and pray prayer number 50 for Kathy for her birthday. Oh God, our times are in your hands. Look with favor, we pray, on your servant Kathy, as she begins another year. Grant that she may grow in wisdom and grace, and strengthen her trust in your goodness all the days of her life. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And across the page, we have prayer 53. We'll pray for Eric and Dana as they partake on a rare trip away from us.
Not too rare.
Let us pray together.
Oh God, our Heavenly Father, whose glory fills the whole creation, and whose presence we find wherever we go, preserve those who travel, in particular Eric and Dana. Surround them with your love and care, protect them from every danger, and bring them in safety to their journey's end, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our Tuesday night at St. Timothy's continues. Our last one before we take a break, we're going to kill off David on Tuesday night. That should be fun. Or not. We get to hear the battles, intricacies, the scheming that makes Solomon king instead of his older brother. We read about cutting a baby in half. It's going to be a fun Tuesday night. Dinner's at 5, Eucharist at 6, educational program follows. Come to one of the three, come to two, or all of the three. All are welcome. Bring a friend. After Tuesday, we're going to take July and August off. We'll pick up again with Tuesday nights in September. If you have an educational program, a Bible book, something you would like to be studied on our Tuesday night program, let me know, and we'll think that it works. There's so much in our scripture, in our history, and I don't always know what you want to learn about. So come to me and tell me what you want to talk about on Tuesday nights. I picked the David story because I love this story. I find it just absolutely fascinating and filled with amazing stories we never read from our lectern. So that continues. some sadder news. We have been graced with the presence of Suzanne Purdy on our organ for several weeks. And Suzanne will continue with us through the month of July and August 6th. And after that, she is going to be moving away from Yakima. Oh. we will revel in her presence while she is here. We'll try to plan some celebration for your final Sunday. We can give thanks that she has been with us much too short a time, but we are grateful for the gifts she has shared with us. So, please let her know how much you've enjoyed her organ playing, because I know I have, and I know Kathy has.
Hallelujah!
I leave on vacation. I'll be in the office Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday this week, and then I'll be back on the 19th of July. Sabrina will be in the office. Joan will be leading our Sunday services, and we'll have the pastoral care home. We are in good hands, and I will miss you, but we're also looking forward to our trip to the Oregon Bach Festival to hear a lot of music and relax. So, any other announcements for the good of the church? Yes, there is one. Kathy should have spoken up. This was the last Sunday of our choir also. So please, when you see a choir member, thank them for the gifts they have been giving to this community. They have done such a wonderful job. I think we're planning to return in September.
First Sunday after Labor Day.
First Sunday after Labor Day, the choir will be back. I'm sure she will let us know when the first rehearsal is, probably the Thursday before that.
Yay.
A wonderful blessing. I think we've made some pretty good music around here.
Yes, absolutely.
Let us stand for our final one.
Thank you.
anymore to go